He's not a monster. He's just a person.
I have to admit that Nesmin is someone I think about almost every day. I wonder whether we are doing enough for him.
Why is Nesmin here? In the case of Nesmin, we tend to focus on ancient Egypt, but between that time period and today, we have a couple of millennia of history that tends to get overlooked. These mummies and also other excavated artifacts were deployed very specifically to make certain statements. We can actually learn quite a lot. Mummies are basically bodies, and our bodies contain all of the traces of our lived experiences. A lot of these experiences may not necessarily make their way into any documentary records.
So while texts and images really give us an ideal, bodies, on the other hand, give us a picture of the real life as experienced by Egyptians. European and American museums have been collecting mummies for a very long time, even as our idea of what a museum should be has changed.
To have a mummy in an art museum is really interesting, but it's still a little problematic because is a mummy a work of art? I would argue it's not, right? He or she is not a work of art. The sarcophagus might be. You know, visitors come in and they see this individual on display. How many of them think about this as a person?
Would that person have been distressed or honored to have his body on display? We do know a great deal about ancient Egyptian beliefs in the afterlife and the preservation of the body. The Egyptians themselves treated these bodies as art. So the process of mummifying a body turns it from being a dead person into a statue. On the other hand, this is also human remains, and our understanding of respect that is due to a body, to a person, it needs to be brought into this conversation.
Do we get to decide what ancient Egyptians would have wanted? You know, after having dug them up, oh, well, they would have been okay with this.
If we wanted to send Nesmin back to Egypt, for instance, this is not an option that we have. A non-royal Egyptian body, there are so many of them in museums, Egypt can't deal with them.
Institutions that have them have a responsibility then to continue caring for them.
But I still feel really uneasy about it, and I continue to think about what we can do better for Nesmin.
By hiding but not removing the body, you open up the questions for conversation. There are a number of different voices that we need to listen to, and these voices have different perspectives, and we're never going to arrive at a yes or no answer. I think, in fact, the conversation and the listening are the most important things that we can bring.